You want to play first? Well, he's got a bunch of veteran armors and all that nonsense, so yeah. This hand is fine-ish. Would we like to mulligan? And no. I think I would like to play Islands and then draw Errant Ephemeron. Don't really want to play Spell Snare or all that junk, so play this. And land cycle for second island. Wonder if he has a lightning helix. So we can just cycle this bad boy in a turn. Get our planes. Play it. Play Stinky Imp. Pass. Awesome. Maybe he'll helix it. Pause. Then we can dredge and then pilfer or something. I actually want to trade this guy off as quickly as possible. Oh, you kept a two-lander, did you? I wonder if you just drew that. You might have just drawn that. And Baloth. Okay, that's not bad. So we're going to attack for one and then ship a turn. This guy's fading. I'm not really too concerned since I've got the imp. Really want to trade it off. Really would have liked to trade it off last turn. And he has a Meadow Boon. Yeah, you can have that as much as you want. Ooh, that was pretty hot. We're attacking from all angles. So we'll leave up that. And see what he does. Now we know he has Lightning Helix, we know he has Tribal Flames, we know he has Engineered Explosives and Drag Down. So Echoing Truth at this point, ooh, Flicker Wisp, are you going to flicker our Stinkweed Imp? Seems like you are. Get a little damage in there. Alright, I don't mind that. Don't mind that at all. And we can just put our Assault on the back burner for now. Really want to start dredging. The game's going to play out pretty well. Just because we have Death Knight and Pilferers. At this point, Echoing Truth can serve as a counter to Tromp the Domains. Because if, you know, we're just sort of all sitting here and he draws Tromp, then that's a lot of damage, and I don't really want that to be a fate. Don't want to die to Tromp the Domains. Personally, not really good. Feud Killer's Verdict? Oh, wait, no. Do you want to attack first and then play Feud Killer's Verdict? 3, 4. Penumbra Spider. Yep, you've got a spider. That is fine. I do not care about your Penumbra Spiders. Ooh, that's good. Marsh Flitter. So, go ahead and play that bad boy. I suppose it would have been better to Logic Knot or Drag Down. But we're certainly not attacking into this Penumbra Spider, so we're just going to chill here for now. And I think it's pretty obvious that he has Lightning Helix. Those are the first two lands he played. He's been leaving it open every turn, so we can just assume that he's got that in his hand. I really would like you to attack us. Please. Please. Alright, so this is probably a Feud Killer's Verdict. Yep. That is fine. I have the feeling that he may be attacking next turn, and hopefully it is not with Tromp the Domains, because I don't have Traumatic Visions anymore. But we're going to keep on playing our lands. So, this is the test. Does he have Tromp? Does he not have Tromp? I think he has Helix, so hopefully the other card in his hand is not Tromp, and Tromp is nowhere near the top of his deck. We certainly do not have anything. I suppose we should not play more lands in the case that we draw careful consideration, because we kind of want to discard lands at this point. And I don't really like discarding spells when we have none. So 1, 2, 3. This looks like engineered explosives if I had to put money on anything. Which isn't the worst, I suppose. We can Echoing Truth or Stinkweed Imps. No, maybe he doesn't have Helix, that's odd. Don't want to Echoing Truth though, because I want to dredge, so Echoing Truth is going to get rid of that. So he's going. So what happens now? So he is going to attack us with a lot of stuff. This is dying. These would die. I want these to die. So what we're going to do is end up blocking the spider and the Dirkwood Baloth, sack the token, bounce the giant, take 3 damage. Yeah. I can deal with that, so we'll go ahead and let that happen. Okay, so he's going to attack, and we're going to be dredging and all that nonsense. So we'll let him do whatever he wants to do. Surprise, he is attacking with everything. Block, block. Alternatively, we can kill his Meadow Boon. That would put a counter here and here. That's actually maybe better if we think he has Lightning Helix. Kind of like that. So that would let us, yeah, I like that more, I think. So we'll go ahead and do that, yeah. Then we're going to Echoing Truth this giant warrior. Goodbye. And sack our goblin token that we blocked with. So, now we're going to dredge. Boom. Oh. Well, there goes our tromp, unfortunately. And so now what we can do is attack for 1, play Stinkweed Imp, pilfer. We can also pilferers or pilferers and attack there. I like that, I think. Kind of sucks that, let's see, out of that or get the, if we pilfer or pilferers, then we can, yeah, I like that. Pilfer, pilferers, attack for 4, play Stinkweed Imp. Although if he has Lightning Helix, that's bad, because then he helixes and attacks down to 9, so we could just not attack with the rogue. I actually like that a little bit better. So we'll go ahead and play that. Don't want to die to any shenanigans. Yeah, looks like he's just going in. Probably with the Penumbra Spider. And yeah, we're going to snap block. Put the brakes on, buddy. This will make it so that his spider won't be able to attack through our pilferers anymore. Unfortunately, we don't have Tromp the Domain, so our out is going to be. Yeah, you can have the Kitchen Finks, buddy. Our out is going to be finding Una, I believe. So we should keep on dredging. And now, I think we can pilfers back. So what I kind of want to do is hold this pilfers for a removal spell in case. So find Una, play it, or play Death Denied then. We can also just play Death Denied for a bunch. Or play the pilferers. I got it. We'll play the pilferers, then trade it off, and then death knight it back. So we can pilferers back our errant ephemeron. And then start attacking with that. And then play our Stinkvenom to kill his Baloth. So let's see what he has. Unfortunately, we lost our Tromp, so these aren't doing very much. 4, 5, 6. Is this a Tromp that domains? I certainly hope it is not. It is. Curses. Well, probably means we're dead to a burn spell, unfortunately. So yeah, so I think we're just gonna block here, block here, block here. How much are we taking? We're in 15, so this is 8, 14, 15. Are we dead? Let's see. Basically, this is canceling. All three of our creatures are canceling out this, so we're taking 6. 14. Yeah, I guess we get a 1. Fade the burn. It's lovely. Leaving his Aether Snider, or leaving his spider token. So what do we have to do? We have to 1, 2, 3. Geez, this is bad. We have to dredge, and what happens if we dredge? We're on 1. Might have to death deny. So if we dredge, I think we have to get back Marsh Flitter at this point. Which means can go for 2. So I think I'm dredging Stinking Imp here isn't going to do anything. So I want to be able to draw land. Cancel. Absorb this. Well, that's something. Let's see. That's basically nothing, actually. All right. So we're going to get back Marsh Flitter and Warren Pilfers. Because we want to be able to pilfer his back Una. We aren't really concerned too much about dying to burn. Or we aren't really concerned too much about. Yeah. He's, obviously healing. He's knew it. All right, there you go. Well, sorry I couldn't give you too much of too many videos. Obviously, round one, et cetera, et cetera. But in terms of how the draft ended up playing out, it felt like there were more people in black-white than in the first pack than the last, than the third one, because we saw a lot of Bound and Silences. And, but nothing nearly on the level of that concentration in the first pack. So it seemed like either the distribution was slightly off or that too many people started in that and then moved out. Think we're gonna go ahead and sign up for another one of these things. 11? Sure, you can do that. Awesome. Moto Rich. And so, but yeah, it seemed like, black was open. It seemed like blue or white was sort of open. Green was obviously not open, and yeah, I don't know. It was just It was a very weird first pack to navigate, and I'm not really sure where how we could have done things differently other than maybe trying to go for five color more a little more aggressively with the Vivid Lands and just hoping that it was there in a later pack just be out of by virtue of having a lot of mana fixing early, we would have access to basically all of the whatever good cards we saw late, which is sort of what we ended up doing in this in the sense that we ended up blue black splashing green white, but we didn't prioritize the mana fixing nearly as enough or nearly as highly as if we were trying to actively go for a five color green strategy. I don't know. Yeah, this is a difficult draft to, and I only hope that you enjoyed it. So I will see you next time and happy drafting.